Hi, sorry it's took me so long to get a video going, but my son's finally sleeping. Yes. Jesus, half two in the morning and he's finally sleeping. Lost all track of time, lost all track of days. What a mental time this is, man. Anyway, this video I want to talk about Adele, right? there's a story that Adele has got divorced, right? And she's had to pay loads of money to her ex-husband, right? And it's just funny the reaction. Now, for this video, we will presume that it's true because I don't know if this is true or not. There's only really one source for it, but everybody's jumping on that source, and so we'll assume it's true just for the sake of it, right? Just for the laugh. So we'll start off with the article, right? Because it's just brilliant. This happens to men all the time. It happened to Bezos, the Amazon guy. His ex-wife is now in like the world's rich list. I think she's actually in like the top 10 or something like that of richest people in the world, and she hasn't done anything. You know what I mean? She got that money because of who she was married to. The whole thing is clearly unfair. Doesn't make any sense, but it happens like that, and when it happens like that, women are always the same. They never say, that's out of line, that's out of order. They never say that she's cheap. They never say that she's a deadbeat. They never say anything like that. It's usually you go, girl. She deserves it. Blah blah blah. You know. But when it happens the other way around, it's a funny change of attitude the women seem to have. But we'll show you what I mean. We'll start with this article here, right? Look at this article. Adele's rumored divorce settlement is not equality at work. It says Catherine Singh, right? This isn't what women meant when they demanded gender parity. Yes, we already know that. We know that's not what women meant. We know what gender parity means, but we know that that's not what women meant when they said gender parity, right? Or gender equality. The problem with women, if the problem, there's fucking loads, but one of the problems with women is they never just say what they mean. I seen a video the other day, it's pretty old anyway, but it got rehashed on Twitter the other day. It was the manslator, like a translator for men, so that when their wife says something, it can translate it in simple terms for a man. It's a funny video, it's quite funny, you know. And the guy saying to his wife, do you mind if I go golfing? And she says, no, that's fine. And it translates to, that's not fine, you know. And although it's funny and it's just a joke, it just made me think, you know, why don't women just say what they mean? What I mean, if it's not fine, say it's not fine. I mean, stop this. Stop the stupid games. Stop the subliminal messages. Stop the cryptic clues. Just fucking say what you mean. And you'll get a lot further in life, by the way. And you might actually get what you want. Oh, women can never get what they want. Well, maybe you will if you learn to say what you want, fuck's sake. Speaking in code all the time. When women said they wanted gender equality, we knew they didn't mean gender equality, you know. Just like when women say, believe all women, you know, they don't mean believe all women, they mean believe specific women who are left-leaning and who are doing damage to the right. That's what they mean when they say believe all women, you know. It's just the way it works, you know. It's really a great day to be on the internet, right? Don't use it then. Don't use that man's invention that is such a burden on your life. If you're a woman, do fuck off. I mean, fuck off. I mean, you know that you are not forced to use the internet. Did you know that? And even if you are forced, you don't even need to interact with people. You can go on Netflix or some shit, you know what I mean? You don't need to interact with people. So stop complaining about something that you don't have to do. Do you know what I'm saying? It's just, you know, it's really a great day. It's really a great day to be standing in the bathroom. Right, well, don't then. Why do you sit in the living room? For fuck's sake. You don't need to be on internet if it's such a burden for you. So don't do then. Fucking idiot. we're looking at you, Twitter trolls, because all trolls are men, did you know that? And all trolls only troll women, did you know that? But right now it is an especially bad time to be a lady online. Lady. Because it turns out that in a global pandemic, not only are people spending more time on the garbage fire that is Twitter, don't use it then! But some of their opinions are getting increasingly more problematic. That means she doesn't agree with these opinions, and these opinions should be silenced, and the people sharing these opinions shouldn't be allowed to use the internet. That's what she means. On April the 6th, a Los Angeles court granted singer Adele's request to keep the details of her divorce from ex-husband Simon Konecki sealed. The British songstress and her former boo, I fucking hate that word, were married for 2 years before splitting in April 2019. Such a black word, isn't it? Boo. Fucking... God's sake. Boo. Oh, God. The couple share a 7-year-old son named Angelo. While the actual facts of a divorce are to remain private, rumours started swirling almost immediately that the singer has been ordered to pay her ex $140 million of her reported $190 million net worth. And this is the tweet here. I'll go through this tweet later, right? And it says, judge rules that she has to pay ex-husband of 3 years over $140 million in nasty divorce settlement. Now, ex-husband of 3 years, but I think they've actually been together for like well over a decade or something. They've only been married for three, whatever. It's important to emphasise that none of this has been confirmed, and with all the speculation around the terms of the separation, people might be potentially misinterpreting the fact that $140 million is the sum they're splitting in the divorce, not what Konecki is entitled to. By the way, if there's any truth to the rumours, these February photos of Adele make a lot of sense. The photos of Adele pointing at the camera and shouting or something, right, would be annoying having the media following you around all the time. By the way, she's recently lost a lot of weight, right, and she looks much better for it, right, obviously, right, and that's annoyed all the fat women, right, not because she's lost weight. They don't hate her now because she's lost weight, they hate the fact that she's happy. Because when she lost the weight, she was supposed to be miserable and unhappy, you know, because she was mid-size or body positive before, and now she's skinny and skin and bone, you know, and whatever else they call slim women, which is perfectly acceptable for some reason, but it's not acceptable to call them fat asses. Regardless of whether or not this exact number is what Konecki would receive, in California, where Adele officially filed for divorce, spouses are entitled to half of the partner's income and assets during the period they were married. Yes, and it's fucking despicable. I still don't know why people do this. It's fucking unreal. According to an April 2019 article, in 1 year alone, thanks in part to her wildly successful tour, Adele's net worth jumped from $69 to $182 million. She took home $55 million from the tour alone. I mean, it's nice work if you can get it. By the way, just to be clear, right, I've probably heard them and I just don't know it, but I could not name one Adele song. I have no idea. As I say, I might have heard her songs on the radio and I just don't know it's her. I might even like some of the songs, I just don't know. But I couldn't name an Adele song. I have no fucking clue about her career at all. So our girl, Adele, our girl, you know, I bet she's not our girl anymore now that she's lost the weight, has earned some loot, and it would be nice if she could keep it. Yes, that's what the famous footballers, basketball players, actors, you know, businessmen, that's what they all think as well. It would be nice if they could keep the money that they earned, you know, that would be nice, you know. It would be nice if some of the boxers could keep their earnings, you know, rather than ending up in a situation where they have to sell their belts and medals and stuff because they've been fleeced, you know. That would be nice, you know, but you don't give a shit about them because they don't have a vagina. Or at least not be forced to give more than half of it to her ex-husband. But to be honest, regardless of the details of it, see this as well, see these TBH. Right, I understand doing this shit on Twitter, right, I get it, because you've got a limit, but when you're writing an article, don't use TBH, just write to be honest, okay? It's fucking unprofessional and ridiculous, Jesus, TBH, fuck's sake. And if you don't know what that means, there's another thing, if you're somebody who just happens to not know what that means, you're starting this and he goes, but TBH, and you're like, TBH? What the fuck does TBH mean? So then you end up looking, right, what does TBH mean on Google? And then you get loads of companies with the initials TBH, you know? What is it, the Trust Bank of Honduras? Is that what she's talking about? And you end up with this crap, just trying to figure out what the fuck she means, and then you, when you find out that it's to be honest, you then think, oh, why didn't you just fucking say that then? God, TBH, fucking unprofessional gimp. Regardless of the details of Adele's divorce, don't you mean ADS? Adele's divorce settlement. The most egregious part of this whole debacle has been the online response. Some men online are pretty stoked at the prospect of Adele handing $140 million to Konecki, tweeting that Konecki deserves a large amount of money. Now, see, what they're doing there is they know that he doesn't deserve that money. They know that he hasn't earned that money. They know that she earned that money, and they only have that money because of her. They all know that. What they're doing is they're now throwing it in your face, in women's face. That's what they're doing. They don't believe for a second he should get that money, but they're just throwing it in women's face and saying, no, he deserves it. He deserves it, just to let you know what it feels like every time you fucking bitches say that shit when a rich man goes through a divorce to some fucking nobody, some bum who ends up getting half his fucking money. God, I remember Bill Burr talking about this, and he was talking about a basketball player, I can't remember which one, it could be anyone, and he was talking about the wife that got the big payout from the divorce, and he says she's never even threw a fucking Nerf ball. She never had a layup or anything, and she gets all that fucking money. And this makes men angry because it's clearly unfair. Now it's unfair for you, woman, and you don't like it for some reason. And another thing, Adele's divorce, by the way, is all about the author of this article. I was unaware of that, but now I know. And even more specifically, a whole lot of them are seemingly perplexed, arguing that isn't this equality, even when it comes to divorce settlements, what women, and specifically spooky feminists, wanted? No, they're just saying this is what you called equality when it was happening the other way around. They're just playing you at your own game. This guy's saying here, when men suffer this, everybody will keep quiet. Now Adele has to pay it to her ex-husband, and feminists want to talk. Yes, dear feminists, this is what real equality looks like. It's not all rainbow and unicorns. Deal with it. And sorry, gents, but the answer is no, and for several reasons. Yes, we know the reason. It's one reason. It's because you're a fucking hypocrite. That's the reason. You're a hypocrite. That's the reason. Firstly, a lot of people online are making comparisons between Adele's situation and that of Amazon CEO Jeff Bezos, whose 2019 divorce from wife made tabloid headlines. And finalising the divorce, she was transferred 19.7 million shares of Amazon, a holding value of $38.3 billion. Jesus Christ. And one that places her as 22nd on the Bloomberg Billionaires Index. There you go. I thought it was top 10, but there you go. A ranking of the world's 500 richest people. While this is a hefty amount of money, and on the surface makes comparisons seem more valid, it's important to note that Bezos still retains a 12% stake worth $114 billion, not to mention his other assets. So it doesn't matter that he got all that taken from him because he's still got enough. Seriously? But when you break it right down, you know, so she's saying he's now worth $114 billion. He's legit the wealthiest person in the world. $38 billion is a drop in the bucket. See, this is the thing. It's a drop in the bucket for him. She doesn't understand these same laws apply to poor men. Men who don't have money, men who have one job, you know, they get divorced, they have to give that much. I mean, what are we talking here? She's to get $38 billion, he's left with $114 billion, you know, so it's fucking unbelievable, man. So he's still giving her a lot of money then. That happens to the average guy. He doesn't have the $114 billion, you know. He has to find a smaller place to live. You know, maybe even move in with his parents or something. Oh, God, man. Doesn't matter. And that's another thing. It doesn't matter that it's a drop in the bucket for him. That's completely irrelevant. But perhaps what sets Adele and Basil's situations apart most is that Mackenzie, who was married to him for more than 25 years, played an early and integral role in the growth as a company's first employee and someone who helped draft the company's initial business plan. And this here, Stan says in a tweet here, motherfucking feminists are angry because Adele will pay her ex 140 mil. But they didn't make a sound when Bezos paid his ex 30 mil. During Tiger Woods Saga 2, they were mute. Aye, that's another good one. Tiger Woods, he's another one. Did his missus, who by the way was a domestic abuser, remember she attacked him with golf clubs, did his missus ever make a putt? Did she ever make a putt? No. Did anybody ever pay to watch her make a putt? No. Did she make games for the PlayStation? No, she didn't. Nobody bought her game for the PlayStation. Plus, if we're going to talk about equality, what about the fact that even in Canada, women still own land there is? We can't go one of these discussions with a fucking buffoon without them bringing this up. Yes, women earn 75 cents for every dollar earned by a man. Yes, that's true. On average. Do you not know how averages work, sweetheart? Are you that fucking stupid that you don't know the mathematics that 7-year-olds learn? Seriously, are you that stupid? The numbers are even more ghastly for Indigenous women. Don't care. Women of colour don't give a fuck. And transgender women, I really don't care. As well as women who are new to Canada, really don't give a fuck. I don't give a fuck at all. Because it's against the law to pay them less, you know. And here's another thing, I mentioned this before, right, but wouldn't there be like mass strikes if it was the case, right, that let's take a supermarket, right, and you had a checkout, somebody working at the checkout, right, and the man was getting paid more than the woman just because he was a man, nothing to do with experience or anything like that, just because he was a man. Men driving buses got paid more than women driving buses just because they were men. Wouldn't there be mass strikes all over the country? Like, all over the country? Wouldn't there be, like, huge fucking protests, not just with women, but men as well, protesting the fact that men just get more money just because they're men? Of course they would. But this doesn't happen. So it can't possibly be true, because there would be a fucking massive outrage. But the thing is, these people, these idiots, they know that it's not true. They just throw it out there as a bit of the part of their gishgallop shit, you know, that's all it is. Just to make it sound like they're oppressed when they're not. Imagine wanting to be oppressed. Fucking sickening, man. Not to mention that a lot of these responses seem to just be for the sake of getting back at women. Yes. After all the years you've done this shit. Yes. It feels like a lot of folks on Twitter want Adele's husband to take her for all she's got. Yes. Because Adele's one of you, remember? Not anymore now that she's slim. But when she was fat, she was one of you. Right? So yes. We want your hero. We want your hero. Or heroine. We want your hero to go through what our heroes went through. You know? That's what we want to happen to you. Because we've watched our heroes, and when I say heroes, I'm not just talking about sportsmen, I'm talking about our fathers and our uncles and our grandfathers and stuff. We're talking about real fucking heroes to us. We've watched them go through it. And you smiled, and you said she deserved it, and you mocked them for having any argument against it, you know, and you loved it, and you said she deserved it. So now we want your heroes to go through it, because then maybe you will learn something. You won't, but maybe you'll understand what it feels like, you know? Who knows? Because typically men have been the ones in Adele's shoes, sharing the fortunes with ex-spouses. Right, here we go. I've not read any further here, so I'm guessing she's going to somehow say that women deserve to get it, whereas men don't, or something, right? Let me guess, the phrase power dynamic will be used at some point, right? Some point during this article, right? They love that. Women have historically... Oh, God, here, history, right? Women have historically been the financially weaker party. What? Right, okay. What's that got to do with today? Sorry, I don't understand. What's that got to do with today? Men used to be conscripted But what's that got to do with today? Sorry, I'm missing the point here. A position that stems from long ingrained gender roles. Aye, because remember when women were conscripted? That was horrible, wasn't it? Oh, that's right, that didn't happen. That's right. You were never forced to fight, kill and die for a cause that you may not believe in. Ah, that's right. I remember that you never had to go through that shit. Only men did. Ah, it's funny. That's horrible, isn't it? Horrible. Oh, no, you're not mentioning that, though. Well, it's funny. All right, okay. You're just mentioning that women had to stay at home while the man worked in a coal mine. Fucking unbelievable, man. Women working in a home and out of the workforce for extended periods of time. Right. When women were working in the home, right? See, when women were working in a home, right? Prisoners in their own home. What were the men doing? What were the men doing? Were they down the pub? Were they just down the pub just having a few beers? Is that what they were doing? Or were they breaking their backs 50, 60 hours a week to provide for the woman who's working at home? Really now? Unfucking real. Why does Dale have to compensate? Well, because that's the law. Isn't that what you women say? That's the law. That's the rules. Isn't that what you say? No? Seems kind of counterproductive. Also, here we go again. TBQH, TBQH. Oh no. I don't know what TBQH means. Now I need to look that up. TBQH. What's this? The Bank of Quarterly Hourlies or some shit? What the fuck does that mean? I don't know. Is that what she's talking about? Bank stuff? What are you talking about? Why do you just write, to be quite honest though? I mean, why do you just write that? Aren't you a professional writer? You've already droned on for fucking ever. Why don't you just add those four words? Fucking hell. TBQH. Fuck's sake, man. Don't you think women have already had to put up with enough shit as an entire gender without Adele having to fork over 2/3 of her hard-earned fortune as a way to appease men, saying, you asked for equality, here it is? Wait a minute. So women have put up with enough shit as an entire gender. You said 2 paragraphs ago that a woman got $38 billion in a divorce settlement and she didn't do anything, you know? I mean, really, in the big scheme of things, she didn't do anything, right? Did you get some of that? Because she's a woman, and when women suffer together, that must mean they win together, right? Because some women went through some shit at some point that affects them all. This is worse than the blacks, I tell you. It's worse than the blacks. Oh, blacks fucking years ago went through some shit. Right, and? Well, that means I'm a victim today, hundreds of years later. No, it fucking doesn't. Okay. No, it doesn't, okay? Fucking hell, man. Never enough with these cunts. From Catherine of Aragon being cast out by her wayward husband, to women in the US and some provinces in Canada having to fight for their right to choose. You mean to kill their babies? Just say kill babies, because that's what you mean. We've put up with endless amounts of BS. Can we and Adele not have one nice thing? What's the nice thing? Being able to skip the law that applies to everybody? Well, at least fans will have this to look forward to. Her next album, God help us. Her next album's going to be about being slim. You know, and not being a fucking lard arse anymore, and that will really annoy the shit out of you. So here's the original tweet here, the one that I read out. Women say they want equal rights to men, right? Pay up. Doesn't make sense when he cheated. You see, now I've got a reply to this one here, right? And my reply, if you watch The Wire, you'll know what I'm referring to here, right? But my reply should show up. It doesn't actually show up at the top for some reason. I said, feminist pushed for no fault divorce. You wanted in the game, right? Now you're in the game. That's a reference to The Wire, you know, when fucking can't remember that guy's name, guy that works in the bar, and he desperately wanted in the game, you know, and then he ends up having to do jail time, and his lawyer says to him, you wanted in the game, right? Now you're in the game. Well, now she's... doesn't make sense when he cheated. Well, that's what no-fault divorce is. You women pushed for this. You pushed for no-fault divorce so that you could just get divorced whenever you want, no matter the cause, and there's no fault given to you for cheating. You know, so... Well, now you got what you wanted, and now you're crying about it. It's just... it's unbelievable, isn't it? Next time you hear a man ask for a prenup, just remember this feeling. In his name we pray. You see, on Twitter, you can see most people are having fun with us, calling him King. It is like loads of memes. Get that bag, King. That's a reference to the women who say, get that bag, Queen, when a woman takes a man for his money. Nah, this is an L. Adele is a treasure. Yeah. Everyone wants equality until it's time to be equal. What a great quote that is. Isn't that a fucking great quote? Great quote. Everyone wants equality until it's time to be equal. I'm going to like that. That's a great fucking quote. Don't know what that's about. All the men in the replies thinking this is equality. Karma will catch up to you, bros. Aye. But it is equality, though. You just cannot handle it. This is literal equality. Men have been going through this for decades. For decades. For decades. And he cheated on her. Like, damn. He's mad as fuck. She's out here looking fine as wine now. No, this was before these photos were released where she looks a wee bit better, you know. And by the way, she looks a wee bit better, but, you know, there's a lot of tucking going on. I'm not having a go at her, right, because, you know, I would say well done, losing that weight. That must have been tough. Maybe he wouldn't have cheated if she did it earlier, but I'm just saying, you know, just saying. Yeah, nobody mad after 140 million. I know. I don't think he's mad that she's looking fine after they got divorced. You know what I mean? Jesus, man. There was a joke earlier from Scotch and Rye. It's a Scottish comedy, right? It was on at New Year, and he has to identify the body, you know, and the police, he lifts the cover off the body, and the guy Ricky Fulton, class act. He then starts crying, you know, and he says, the policeman says, oh, you must have been really close to your wife. He says, that's not my wife. He says, well, why are you crying? He says, because that's not her. It's just fucking, that's what he's like now. He's like, I don't give a fuck about Adele. Why would I care about her? That's why I divorced her. Oh, man. I like Adele. She seems like good people. It's a shame it happened to her, but this is a win. Who the hell was her lawyer? It, in a way, it shouldn't matter who a lawyer is. It's the law, right? That's what women keep saying. It's the law. It's the law. 140 of 109, how does that compute? I think just like that woman said in an article, again, this is all rumour, we don't know the facts, that it's the 140 that will be split. He won't be getting the 140, but still a lot of money. It doesn't let the internet be the internet. That's false. Let's see. This thread proves what I've known for years. Women don't want equality. They want preferential treatment. Yeah. Well, we've all known it for years. There's a lot of these as well, laughing videos. And it's because men don't get a victory like this very often. It's not often you get news like this. And even then, we don't even know if it happened. But we don't really get news like this a lot. So can you just let us enjoy it for once, you know? He doesn't deserve the money, and he shouldn't be getting that much money off her. She's the one who made it. But this is what men have to go through, so this is just a bit of Schadenfreude. This is just a bit of karma coming back at women. You're just going to have to let us enjoy this one, you know? And by the way, I say that, as I say, I have nothing against Adele at all. Don't know anything about her, except what she looks like. And that she's a singer, and I don't know any of her songs. World is tired of feminism. Yep. Her next album going to be fire. Again, I'm guessing she sings songs, I don't know, about being rejected or something, maybe something like that, or is she just a typical woman singer about men being pigs and women are just great? Is she one of those singers? Fuck. Man, if I had money, prenup finna be my middle name, because ain't no way. If you had the money, but if he had the money, you wouldn't want prenup to finna be his middle name, would you? Finna. I mean, it's bad enough when joggers do it, but see when white people talk like that, I know she's not white, but see when white people talk like that, really does my head in. Finna. Fuck does that mean? I think it means fitting to. I think that's right. It's fitting to, I think. Y'all are so mad at this, but when the roles are reversed, it's get your coins, sis. Yep. Yes, King. Get your money, King. It's gross because you're supporting a cheater getting half of the money she earned for betraying her and breaking her heart. Yes. Isn't it horrible, dear? It's horrible, isn't it? Aye. Did you have anything to say when women were doing this for decades? No, I don't think you did. I'm not going to check, so I can't be bothered. But I'm willing to bet, you know, I'm willing to bet the billion that Jeff Bezos' ex-wife is going to donate to me on PayPal after watching this video. I'm willing to bet that the universe said a fucking word every time a man went through this. Not one word, except maybe, you go girl. So fuck off. Half, she pays half. Better, but still unreasonable if he didn't make clear contributions. Did you see this when it happened to him? I bet she didn't. LeBron James, right? He's an asshole, but he's very rich, right? If he divorced his wife tomorrow, this bitch doesn't even know her name. But if she walked away, Chantel or something, Chantel, and she got half his money, she'd be like, ah, yes, you go. And now she's complaining about contributions. Do fuck off. Eat the rich, good job, King. This happens to men every day. To rich men, not y'all, relax. That's the thing. It's worse for men who don't have money because they still have to give half away. This is what you don't understand. Chris Rock made this joke a long time ago. Well, joke, it's hardly a joke, but Chris Rock made this observation years ago when he said, it's all right if you're rich because you're still eating. But if you're broke, you know what I mean? You're not eating because you've got to give half your money. So, so don't say to rich men, it won't happen to you. If this guy doesn't have money, that's even fucking worse for him because she still gets half of his nothing. So it's even worse. Fucking women, the Queen speaks. Aye, fucking women out here, you know, slagging off men for not having money. How much money have you got? Your own money. Aye, right. God. Let's see. Ah, okay, so you're a true feminist. Any feminist that thinks different, I don't know what he's talking about. Maybe she was working too long, too hard. She was distant and ignoring his needs. That is what women would say. That is what women would say. Like, I think that's what he's doing there. I'm pretty sure that's what he's doing there. He's doing exactly, writing exactly what women would say. So, I think that's what he's doing there. Good point. I don't think people generally mock men if they show these emotions within reason. What's this here? Women, I don't know what she's talking about at all. Big conversation there. Misogyny, 140. Femininity, minus 100. this dude got the game on lock. I need to take notes. First lesson, don't date a broke chick. Now, I'm looking for fucking Bezos' ex, I'll tell you that. Fuck. Might as well. Fucking hell. Live with her for a couple of years and then get what? 19 billion? I'd be happy with that. I'll tell you what. Bezos' ex-wife, whatever her name is. I'll tell you what, right? I'll stay with you for a couple of years. I won't take the 18 or 19 million, right? A billion, sorry. How about I just take 5? 5 billion, is that okay? Right, okay. So I'll hook up with you for like a couple of years and I'll take 5 billion off. Is that all right? That's a fair deal, right? I mean, hey, I earned it, right? I earned it. Because I was in your company for 2 years, therefore I earned that money. Oh, my God. Another wee tip here, right? I shared this on Twitter earlier, but see if you search on Twitter with the link to the tweet, right? The link to the tweet is there. You get to see all the retweets, which is quite cool. It's a thing that I didn't actually know that for a long time, but it's a good wee feature. Oh, how the tables have turned. Laughing, big king energy. Every time I see men ain't shit, I'm just reply with this. We ain't shit, but we getting paid. I hope this isn't true. I would put that money on your head before I put it in your hands. Word to me. See, why are we hoping it's not true? Didn't he earn that money by being in her company for that long? He was married to her for 3 years, with her for longer. So, didn't he earn that money? I mean, he deserves it, right? He deserves it, right? That's what you would say if it was a woman. Secure the bag, gang. Ugly Vato's winning 2020. Marriage is a scam, I'm telling y'all. Yes. Did you tell y'all that marriage is a scam when Bezos, his ex, was getting all that money? I bet you weren't talking about scam marriages then, right? Of course you fucking weren't. His lawyer showed up to court like, I'm sure she'll be fine with 50 million left in the bank. But again, that's not the point. Isn't the point that she's got money, she'll be alright? That's not the point. He should not be getting that. This is ridiculous. That's fucking ridiculous. I mean, even 70 million, even if it was only half of the... Only. Even if it was only half of the 140 million, 70 million? No. If anything, it should maybe get a couple of million, you know what I mean? Because, you know... But not fucking that. That's ridiculous. This whole divorce game. These lawyers, these fucking big-nosed fucking lawyers must be loving this shit, man. They're the ones that make the real money. God. See, this is just disgusting. Says another woman, by the way. Like, how was she to know that he'd come after her hard work? Well, I know. It's annoying, isn't it? When people get married, it's not out of spite, so divorcing should be seen with the same guys. Fuck that guy. And Jeff Bezos' ex-wife. Fuck her too, right? No? No? Oh, no, you don't have a problem with her. Ah, I see. So you don't have a problem with her, but you have a problem with him. Right. I see how this works. I'm starting to see how this works now. City boys just keep winning and winning this season. How much for a new set of teeth? You're going to slag the guy's teeth off? Seriously? Fucking hell, man. Holy goat, secure the bag. Goals. This next album about to be an all-time great. About to slap. Right, okay. He dropped his crown. I would get my Carol Baskin on for sure. So she would murder him then a bit. I think that's what she's saying. I've never watched that thing on Netflix, but it's been trending that much that I know quite a lot about it because I've been reading people's tweets and stuff, and I've never watched an episode of it. But I'm guessing that she means she'd kill him, because apparently Carol Baskin killed her husband. Apparently, in case any lawyers are watching, apparently. So I heard. No wonder she lost weight. King shit. So excited for Adele to make all that money back in her next album when she exposes his ass. What? The equal rights they wanted, lol. Well, it is. I love equality. Man cheated and is getting $140 million. King behaviour. See, this is just getting right in the face of all these fucking feminists. Y'all are so mad, but if the shoe was on the other foot, get that bag, sis. Exactly. Why would she marry that ugly man's, no queen, man's? That's another fucking... It's another jogger thing, innit, man? Surely first thing he's buying is a set of veneers. Slagging him again. Are you going to slag her looks? You know, you're not going to attack her looks? No. Okay. He cheated on her, and somehow she owes him. I hate it here. I fucking hate it here. Yes, but that's how it works, dear. That's how it's worked for years, and you had no fucking issue with it until it happened to your hero. The woman who's I was going to say CDs, that's how old I am. The woman whose CDs you listen to every fucking night. Yes, it's happening to her now, and you don't like it. But yeah, you liked it when it was happening to all those sports stars and stuff. Isn't that funny? Anyway, I think I've went on enough about that, but hopefully I'll get a chance to make another video soon. I don't know what the subject will be. I've got a lot of stuff open up there, but we'll see. Anyway, thank you very much for listening. Until next time.